did. It started off, I was just a freeloader, you know. That's how it starts, because you don't have a ride, you know. You need a place to crash. And I was always looking for that. And then one time, my friend, I had this friend that I had made named Trog. He was this huge guy, and he was always playing good music. He took me to this place to see a singer named Jerry Jeff Walker. And Jerry Jeff Walker wrote Mr. Bodango, you know. And I went down there, and he was doing just what I'm doing now, you know, singing about being a freeloader and needing a ride, needing a place to crash. But it sounded romantic, like you could get a girlfriend and live like that at the same time. And I remember thinking, I was only 19, but it occurred to me in that moment that the only difference between a freeloader and free spirit was three chords on a fucking guitar. So I went, and the next day after I saw him play, I got a guitar, and I just started following him around Texas, and I would sit in the front row, and I would listen to him sing and learn to play guitar watching him sing. And I would write him these letters, and then I wouldn't send them, and I would wait around to meet him, and I wouldn't tell him. I'd have these speeches planned, and I wouldn't give them to him. And then I started playing bars myself, and I had every record that he'd made, and I always read the liner notes of the records and find out where they record them. And I found out that he was known for recording his records in this town called Luckenbach.
Yeah!
They didn't have a recording studio. They had a bar and a post office in the town, and two houses. Yeah. And he just found himself stuck in that bar one year that lasted for a bunch. And the people that were on his record company thought the better idea than trying to get him into the studio was taking the studio to him. And it worked. He made his best records in there. And I always wanted to play there as soon as I found that out, because it's a bar you can play. And so I sent them my demo. And you know the song, Let's Go to Luckenbach, Texas. It's a thing. To people go, tourists go, yeah. And I wanted that gig, and I sent it tape into to get the gig. They didn't call for a while, and then when they finally did, me and my friends drove out to find it. But it's hard to find because of that song. If there's a sign that says Luckenbach on it, some fuck guy takes it. So there you are, out in the desert with no hope of finding this thing. And we found out we were on this road called the Devil's Backbone Highway, and there was a place called the Devil's Backbone Tavern. And they pulled over and told me that I should go in and ask them how to get to Luckenbach. And when I went in there, like 15 teeth in the whole fucking place. And there was this older woman, frightening to me, I was young. And there was this older woman behind the bar, and I thought, I could probably take her, you know. So I asked her. I asked her, where's Luckenbach? And she was cute. She said, fuck Luckenbach, drink with us. And we did. And the night got over, we had already got our guitars out and singing. And when it was time to pay for our beer, she said we didn't have to. And so we just started going there all the time. And then years later, I made this song up about that old, her name was Virgie. Oh, Miss Virgie, tended bar, shack out in the hills. They never paid her any money, paid up all of her bills. She must have been 80 years old, but her heart was warm and her beer was cold. And she gave away more than she ever sold. She'd be smiling all the time. They used to sing off in the corner, it's like every Friday night. There'd be a loud crowd of cowboys, they'd be bikers and barbed fights. They'd be drinking beer and they'd be carrying on. Not one of them would listen to one of my songs. But old Miss Virgie, she would be singing along. She said she knew them all by heart. And then one night, after the place closed, she poured me a beer. She said, come over here and sit down. You little shit, I got something you need to hear.
She said, life isn't easy getting through. If I won't try to make it tough on you, well, I can tell you right now, if you love what you do, no one's ever gonna get you down. Life too short to worry. She said, life too long to wait. Too short not to love everybody. Life too long to hate. I meet a lot of men that haggle and finagle all the time. Try to save a nickel, maybe make it down. She said, not me, boy, the grocery load. I ain't got no time.
Eat your heart out, you inbred son of a bitch.